Hey Internet, my name is Abby and welcome back to Buzz Aldrin's Space Program Manager. We are still in the campaign mode and we are still making some good progress, but our main concern is currently our fundings. And well, yeah, it's a little bit low, but in 3 seasons we will get the next budget review and then we will hopefully be able to open up new programs. But right now, in this season, I can't launch anything, or can I maybe open up something? Let me have a look. Well, the short-duration lunar flights aren't good. We could do the Zond 5 circumlunar flight, or we could do the Lunar 15 lunar sample return. And well, there are some new features that we are now able to see the goals we have accomplished with one space program, and this is really helpful. Okay. The Zond 5 would give us 3 additional goals. I do not want to see what goals. I want to see, okay, opening costs. Wow, the opening costs are pretty cheap. No, what? Total program costs? Are the opening costs now 335 or 4610? Let me just try this. Let me just try to open up the Zond 5, the Bioscience Lunar Flyby. Let me go over here. No, it's now 4610. Okay, I can't open up this project. This is sad. In this case, yeah, let me just end the season and continue on. Okay, our Mars satellite makes good progress. Unfortunately, this thing is so heavy that I do not have the right rocket for this. The opposing faction has successfully performed the following missions. Orbital flight, duration level 1. The opposing faction has successfully accomplished the following goals. Extended duration level 1, man in space. Okay. And, engineers have graduated. This is good. This is really good. Now we have enough money to open up a thing, but on the other hand, we still have 2 missions to fly. On the one hand, the space plane mission, the joint launch with the space plane, and on the other hand, the joint launch with the, Vostok spacecraft. And let me just assign our Vostok booster to this. And this would cost us 7,864. So I think I will just wait in one additional season to do then a joint launch. I think this could be a good idea. So yeah, let me just skip the season. And well, the Mars M69 makes good progress. Scientists are back or have received an update. This is also good. And now I'm able to do the last mission of the... Or will I do the space plane? Oh, I think I will do the space plane at first. Let me do the joint launch and orbital flight. Wait, I would get joint manned launch prestige gained for 8,200. And let me just go back. If I do the Vostok mission, then I would get joint manned launch for a little bit less money. So I think I will do this first. Let me just schedule this mission. Okay, we need to proceed on. And again, booster. And well, I have learned now that the flight controller is the average of all these skills. So yeah, it makes sense to train up a flight controller with all the different skills to a maximum. And well, this guy would be then the flight controller, and this is pretty interesting. Unfortunately, right now, I do not have really a guy or an employee who can perform well as a flight controller, but yeah, okay. This is cool. Now let me just auto-assign the best candidate. This is Alec Kravitz and Sergey... Is this a S or a G? Can I see this? I'm not quite sure. It's currently hard to read what letter this is. But nevertheless, we are now about to launch a joint launch mission. This is cool. So yeah, I want to end the current season. The Mars M69 makes progress, and now we can launch our joint launch and orbital flight. Let me follow this from the mission control. We are preparing the mission, we are doing the rollout of our booster, and preparing the mission. Huh, this is really taking a while this time. Okay, all systems go. Here we go. Here we go with our R7 RK 72 Problem solved. Very good. 72K Vostok booster and the Vostok spacecraft. So yeah, this is pretty amazing. And we have ignition. And we do have our launch. And we do have again the great Soviet music. This is all the time pretty cool to enjoy this music because this is really fitting to the content. And yeah, so I like this a lot, and I've already talked a lot about this. And yes, now we are having the spacecraft deployment of our first spacecraft. This is good. This is really good. And orbital flight. Orbital flight. Okay, a success. Well done, well done. Now, let's launch our second spacecraft. Oh, the pilot there, cosmonaut, is pretty low, only a skill level of only 53%. So hopefully we won't have an issue, and hopefully he will be able to enter space and to have a rendezvous, or well, not really a rendezvous, but a flight next to the other spacecraft. This would be really amazing. Okay, and spacecraft deployment. Was a success. This is good. This is really good. Now we do have two spacecrafts in orbit. Hopefully they are able to return. Oh no, there's an issue. There's an issue. Problem solved. Wow, random number of 98.37. This is cool. And joint orbital flight. This is cool. Okay, spacecraft A is about to re-enter the atmosphere and to have the re-entry. This is cool. And the re-entry is going on. Okay. Descent, ejection, and cosmonaut landing. And is it a success? I hope so. Yes, it's a success. Okay, spacecraft A is back on Earth. This is amazing. This is really amazing. And now, spacecraft B, re-entry preparations. Now, let's keep fingers crossed that spacecraft B is also able to return back home, and that we can here celebrate the successful joint launch of a manned spacecraft. Okay, descent, ejection, and cosmonaut landing. And a success. Amazing, amazing. Good job, good job. So we are back on Earth, and we managed to complete this mission. This is amazing, and we got 3,000 additional prestige points. This is really helpful for the later part of the game when we like to have the next budget review. Okay, joint manned launch. Okay, let's see if the opposing faction has done anything. The opposing faction has successfully performed the following missions. Uncrewed suborbital flight test, okay. The opposing faction has successfully accomplished the following goals. Gemini uncrewed suborbital flight test, okay. And they have opened up a Mars probe, okay. Then, increased public interest in your program has given you a boost of 7,058 prestige points. This is cool, this is cool. Okay, and budget review. Now we are getting really big money. This is amazing, this is really amazing. And what can we do with this money? At first, let me have a look at my programs. Manage programs. We have finished the major goals, so we can close the PKA space program and the Vostok space program. And rocket programs. I do not think we need the Vostok booster anymore. So let me just close this as well. And then my biggest goal is, of course, to have the N1 booster. Do I need the N1 booster? Let me just see. The rocket, the Proton KD booster. Translunar injection, 5,390 kilograms. I like to go. Can I see this from this point? I'm thinking about the lunar landing with the L3 Soyuz LK. earned. Can we see somewhere the mass? 9,850. Lunar lander. 5,560. This sounds quite heavy. What are the... Let me just check the N1 booster. 11,000. Okay, we need the N1 booster in order to perform this lunar landing. In this case, I think I will start off with the Proton K booster, because I like to launch my interplanetary probe. In this case, let me at first open up this one. Very good. Yes, I would like to be redirected there, but I do have only two scientists available. And what are... Oh no, I can't open up this one. So let me just... the N1 booster. So let me just upgrade the VAB. Oh, this will take some time. This is not good. So maybe I should focus also a little bit on space probes. Or no. Will I? No. No, I will save up some money to open up the Soyuz program. Yeah, this would be more important. Okay, then I do need scientist, as I said. I need to sort them about rocket information. Let me just see. 31, 41, and next page. 41, 50, 57. Okay, this is good. I need 4 guys, so let me remove the best guys with their experience in rocket development. Okay, and the last one, very good. Now we can head over to the space complex and we can at first start working on the Proton K booster. Let me do this. And I think I will also open up the Zond 5, the Bioscience Lunar Flyby. No, the Bioscience Lunar Flyby, yes, yes, I was right. And yeah, let me open up this project. So let's go back to manage payloads. I hope my two scientists... No, they are also bad, but they are good in crewed spacecraft or human-rated rockets. This is nice to know. Unfortunately, this is not really helping me at this point. Yeah. Okay, let me just see my scientists again. I like to sort them to space probes. These are working on something and, well, space probes is really not so much my focus anymore. Well, let's assign these two available scientists to this, because I just need to wait for my money. Okay, now I'm making some progress and let me end the season. Okay, the satellite needs some time. The Proton K booster is only a placeholder, but it's already at 55%. No, at about 60%. This is great. And Zond 5 is at 57%. This is cool. Okay, my two astronauts are back. The opposing faction has opened the Sun probe. They are opening so many programs. How do they do this? I mean, they do not have... Or how do they get the money to do so? This is crazy. This is really an interesting question. Okay, 20,000. So within the next 2 seasons, I will be able to open up finally the... one scientist is available. Let me just grab this one scientist and add him to the Zond 5. That he can help to develop the thing a little bit. Okay, I want to end the current season. Earned 73... 63 and 61. Well done, well done. Opposing faction has opened another program, the Circumlunar Gemini Test Flights in Earth Orbit. This is a little bit crazy. In the last episode, I guess, they opened up the Apollo project. Now they open up the Gemini Test, and if I remember this correctly, then both programs are somewhere in the 40,000s or something like this. Or, well, at least the Apollo program was very expensive. How do they get so much money that they are able to do this and they are not performing so many flights? Hey, CPU, how are you doing this? How are you playing this game? This is crazy. Okay, yes, I can't open up the Soyuz program right now, so I need to skip one additional season. And, well, my scientists have graduated. This is good. This is really good. Okay, now 54,000. Now I'm able to finally open up the two crew ballistic capsules. There are Soyuz 7K, L3, LOK, Earth Orbit. Okay, let me... Yes, I like to open this. Successfully opened. Very good. Now I need to go back to my scientists, and I think I will remove everyone from advanced training, because now I need my scientists. Okay, and these guys. Let me remove them. Okay, this was good. Now I can go over to my Manage Payloads R&D, and I like to start at first with the Soyuz 7K LOK spacecraft. Let's assign the best guys to this. Then we do have the Igla Automatic Docking System crewed spacecraft. I think we need this at some point, but I think it's more important to go for the lander. I think the lander is a little bit more important right now. Okay, then I do have one scientist left over. Okay, the one scientist can work a little bit on the EVA suit. And there we have a lot of time until we need to think about this. And oh, we can't open up the N1 booster, so we are now making some progress. This is good. And I need to check one thing right away. How many flight controllers do I need for the Soyuz flight? 11 flight controllers for an unmanned flight, and no, this was the wrong button. And how many flight controllers for the later, like duration level 3 flight? 13 flight controllers, so I need to hire 3 additional flight controllers. Then I think I should also hire 2 more astronauts. Let me just... Oh, they have all finished their training. That's interesting. I think I should... This will take some time until we finish this research project. Okay, everyone should go to piloting or leadership training. Let me just do this. Okay, and these other ones can learn a little bit more about leadership. Until we are finally able to do the first Soyuz launches. And leadership. Okay, very good. And now let's hire two additional astronauts, just in the case that I'm losing two of them, or that I'm losing some of my astronauts. This would be bad, but I need to be prepared for this. And also there is this rest season, so this is another reason why I should have more of them. Let me also upgrade the building right away. And then, as I said, I need some more flight controllers. Let me just hire 3 of them. Okay, hire these recruits. Okay, now I think it will still take some time until I can do the next flight. I should do some training. This one should learn a little bit more about crew and payloads. This one is good in propulsion. Though no trajectory. And mission operations, also trajectory. Okay, this one can learn a little bit more about mission operations. Okay, and this one can train a little bit more the spacecraft systems part. This is good. Okay, you can learn more about crew and payloads. And this one can learn more. Oh, he's bad. Crew and payloads, I think. Let me boost the skill. Okay, and page number 2. Trajectory. And this one can learn more about spacecraft systems. And this one can learn more about crew and payloads. Okay, very good. So everyone is learning something, everyone is researching something, we are making some great progress. I think I will upgrade also the science building, and Well, I do not need to upgrade the headquarters. So in this case, I think we are now at the end of today's episode, and I'd like you to thank you for watching, and I hope you will be joining me in the next episode when we continue with our campaign mode. In this case, until next time, my name is Levi. See you!